Hello students, welcome to the webinar class. Myself Shankho Ghosh, assistant professor of automobile engineering department at your college. Today the webinar topic is alcohol as an alternative fuel. So in this century, it is believed that the crude oil and the petroleum products will become very scarcely. So day by day, fuel economy of engine is getting improved and will continue to improve. However, enormous increase in number of vehicles has started dictating the demand for the fuel. So therefore, the gasoline and diesel will become scarce and most costly in the near future. So for this reason, researchers and the automobile try to find out the another types of fuel that is called as alternative fuel. So alternative fuels are any material or any substances that can be used as fuels other than the conventional fuels. Conventional fuels means diesel engine. So this conventional alternative fuel is also known as non-conventional and advanced fuel. There are various types of alternative fuels are available, such as biodiesel, bioalcohol. Bioalcohol means ethanol, methanol, refuse drive fuel, chemically stored electricity, battery or the fuel cell, hydrogen, non-fossil methane, non-fossil natural gas, vegetable oil, propane and other various types of biomass are used as an alternative fuel. Now, after knowing about alternative fuels definition, now we need to know the why it is important, why researchers are go for the alternative fuel by the replace of the conventional fuel. The development of an alternative fuel for the internal combustion engine is concerned over the emission problem of the gasoline and the diesel engine. So the combined with the other air pollution system, the large number of automobiles is a major contributor to the air quality problem of the world. So the quite a lot of improvement has been made in reduction of emission from the automobile engine. So day by day, as the number of vehicles increases, so for that reason, emission is also increases. So for this purpose of that, so we need to find out the another way which is replaced by the conventional fuel. Second is the limited of petroleum based fuel. So in this world, there petroleum or the crude oils are limited. So just because of that, so it is more important to find out another or any new kind of fuel which is replace this conventional fuel. Second, third one, it is highly polluted emission though they are produced by this conventional fuel. Next, main requirement of engine operating on alternative fuel to reduce the exhaust emission and replace these fuels with the renewable and environmentally friendly fuels. So it should be easily available and the economically feasible. So for these reasons, we are automakers or the scientists are find out the alternative fuel to replace of the conventional fuel. Now coming to the alcohol as a topic of this webinar. The alcohols are an attractive alternate fuel because they can be obtained from both natural and the manufactured sources. So the liquid fuel, those are chosen for the IC or internal combustion engines because they are easy to store and they have to reasonable good calorific value. So the main alternate for this reason is alcohol. So alcohols are the attractive alternate fuel because they can be obtained from the both naturally and manufactured source, as I told. Methanol and the ethanol are the two kinds of alcohol that seem most promising. The alcohol fuels, are used as an alternative fuel for the engine application just because of these reasons. First one is, it is renewable sources which is available in which is obtained from the both either it may be natural or maybe manufacturing source. So that's why it is renewable sources. Second is, it is high octane number. Next, third is oxygenated fuel and low emission. So for this reason alcohol are used as an alternative fuel. Now need to know the chemical formula of the alcohol fuel. The chemical formula of alcohol is CnH2n+1 and OH. So this is the chemical formula of the alcohol. Now coming to the various kind of alcohol fuel. Basically there are three types of alcohol available. Those are, first one is methanol, second is ethanol, and third one is butanol. So student, let's start with this methanol. Methanol, it's the chemical formula is CH3OH. As I know, the chemical formula of the alcohol is CnH2n+1OH. This is the chemical formula of the alcohol, and the methanol is CH3OH, where N equals to 1. So it is the light, colorless, volatile and flammable liquid with a typically odor. It does not contain sulfur, or it is an complex organic compounds. It gives higher thermal efficiency and it emits less amount of emission. It has high octane number to use with the higher compression ratio. So students, so the reason of the methanol we used as a fuel, those are, it is a light, colorless, volatile and the flammable liquid with a typical odor. That is number one. Number two, it does not contain any kind of sulfur. Number three, it has a high thermal efficiency. Number four, it emits the less amount of emission. And next is, it has a high octane number. So these are the characteristics of this methanol. Hello students. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Up to this, is there any problem or any query?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. I have a query, sir. Sir, it has high octane number. Octane number, I have to use with higher compression ratio. What do you say?
যখন আমার অক্টেন নাম্বারটা বেড়ে যাচ্ছে তখন আমার কম্প্রেশন রেশিওটাকে হাই করতে সুবিধা হবে, তাহলে আমার কম্বাশনটা যেটা হবে সেটা আমি প্রপার ওয়েতে করতে পারব।
ওকে স্যার।
ম্যাম, মুভ টু দ্য নেক্সট স্লাইড।
হ্যালো স্যার, আই হ্যাভ এ কোশ্চেন স্যার।
ইয়া
Sir, what is the volatile liquid?
Volatile means which is highly evolved in your in the atmosphere easily.
Okay, sir.
That's like a petrol. Petrol is a highly volatile.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now next is the production of the methanol. So up to this we can know that the chemical formula or chemical equation of the methanol, that is CH3OH and its this. Now we need to know the how it is produced. So the carbon monoxide and the hydrogens are basically reacts with the help of the catalyst, that's a copper and the zinc oxide, to produce the methanol. So these are the most important method to produce the methanol. Now coming to the steps of this production. First one is carbon monoxide plus 2H2 reacts with and make the CH3OH. Second way, the carbon dioxide and the hydrogen react and produce methanol and the hydrogen. Water. Number three, carbon dioxide and hydrogen reacts and produce carbon monoxide and the hydrogen. And this carbon monoxide and the hydrogen, which is reacts with this hydrogen, and it's produced the CH3OH, that is methanol. So this is the way to find out the methanol. Now coming to the next slide, that is ethanol. The general chemical formula of the ethanol, that is C2H5OH. As we know, the chemical formula of the alcohol, that is CnH2n plus 1 OH. Here n num equals to 2. So this from this equation we get that the ethanol chemical formula of the ethanol, that is C2H5OH. Now coming to the characteristics of this ethanol, so it is capable of mixing with water completely. It has a higher compression ratio so that it allow the more engine power. Number three, it is safer for the transportation and storage due to the high auto ignition temperature than the diesel fuel. So for this reason, it is easy to save for this transportation and the storage purpose. Next, it reacts with the rubber and the causes clogging inside the fuel oil. So this is the demerits of this ethanol. So it is react is the ethanol easily react with the rubber and causes the clogging inside the fuel pipe. And the fluorescent carbon, which is recommended to use the instead of the rubber, which is this fluorescent rubber, which is not reacts with this ethanol. Now coming to the next slides, that is the production of the ethanol. So there are the two types of the method, two methods to produce the ethanol. Number one is fermentation and number two is distillation. Now starting with this fermentation process, where this process is made from the corn and the other starch sources, or the form natural sugar by the fermentation. Common source for this fermentation are included rice, potato, cassava, plus corn and the other grain. So microfuel fermentation of the sugar is used to produce the ethanol mainly. So mainly to produce the ethanol by the fermentation process, we use microfugal sugar to produce the ethanol. This is the another methods to produce the this one is the another method to produce the sorry, to produce the ethanol. That's a distillation method. Manufacturing process was very energy intensive, but it is now less. So in the most modern plants, due to the advantages is distillation technology. Ethanol is commercially produced using either a wet mill or a dry mill process. Wet milling involves separating the grain kernel into its components parts. Those are germ, fiber, protein, and the starch. So these are used for the wet milling method to the fermentation. And in the dry milling process, in this process where the entire grain kernel is grounded into the flour. So these are the two way to the distillation methods to produce the ethanol. For ethanol to use as alternative fuel, most of us water must be removed during the production of the ethanol. So most of the water is removed by the distillation method, but the purity is limited to 95 to 96%. It cannot cover the fully 100%. So it is limited up to 95 to 96%. This mixture is called as the hydrous ethanol, and it can be used as a fuel alone. So in this way, in this distillation method, we produce the ethanol. Now coming to the summary of this, the ethanol prepared from the corn, that is biofuel, by the two methods. First one is dry milling and second one is wet milling. During the dry milling, it takes 40 to 50 hours to produce the ethanol. And in the wet milling, it takes 24 to 48 hours to produce the ethanol. So these are the summary of this production of the ethanol and the comparison of the dry milling and the wet milling. Next is the ethanol from the sugar cane, which is extracted by the following method. First of all, sugar cane is milled in the milling method and refining method. After completing the refining method, it is connected with the goes to the fermentation method, where it takes 4 to 12 hours. After the fermentation, it is going ready to the distillation method, where the water is removed up to 95 to 96% water removed and the dehydration. So in after this way, we find out the proper ethanol. So these are the way of the production, way to produce the ethanol. Now coming to the third type of the alcohol, which is known as butanol. The general chemical formula for the butanol alcohol is C4H9OH. As we know, the chemical formula of the alcohol, that is CnH2n+1OH, here N number is 4. Here N number is 4. So in this way, we got that the chemical formula of the butanol, that is C4H6OH. It is the moderately soluble with the water. It is considered as a biofuel because its 85% strength, which can be used to run the gasoline engine without any changes. It is considered as a toxic than the other alcohol fuel. So these are the disadvantages of this butanol. It is considered as a toxic than the other alcohol fuel. Now coming to the production of the butanol. Most common process which starts with the propylene, which is passing through a hydroformylation and reaction to the becoming butyraldehyde, which is produced with hydrogen to butanol. So here you can see CH3CH2, that is C3H6, that is propylene. Propylene reacts with the hydrogen and the carbon monoxide and to form CH3CH2CH2CHO, that is C4H7OH, which is called butyraldehyde. So after getting this butyraldehyde, then it is reacts with the hydrogen again and to form the butanol. So this is the way to produce the butanol. Now coming to the next slide, this here is the, we can study the properties of the alcohol and the conventional fuel. So let's start with this chemical formula. So chemical formula of the gasoline, that is C8H18, and diesel C12H23, ethanol it is C2H5OH, methanol CH3OH, and butanol C4H9OH. So from this table we find out that the molecular weight of the alcohol are quite low from the conventional fuel. So as you can see here, the molecular weight of the gasoline, that is 95 to 120 gram per mole, a diesel that is 200 gram per mole, but ethanol and methanol are below the 50 gram per mole, and butanol is near to 75 gram per mole. So this alcohol's molecular weight of the alcohol is lower than the conventional fuel. Now coming to the specific gravity. The specific gravity of the gasoline, that is 0.72 to 0.76, and the diesel is 0.82 to 0.88. And in case of the ethanol, the value is 0.790, methanol it is 0.792, and the butanol is 0.794. So here we can see that the specific gravity of the alcohol lies in between the gasoline and the diesel. The stoichiometric ratio of the gasoline, that is 18.6, and the diesel, that is 14.6 and the 14.7. But in case of the alcohol, it is 9 for ethanol, 6.46 is methanol, and 11.1 for the butanol. So the stoichiometric ratio of the alcohol is lower than the conventional fuel. Next is the lower heating value. The lower heating value of the gasoline is 44,300 kilojoule per kg. Diesel it is 41,660 kilojoule per kg. But for the alcohol as an alternative fuel, here the ethanol, it is the value is 26,900 kilojoule per kg. For methanol it is 20,100 kilojoule per kg, and the butanol it is 33,630 kilojoule per kg. So in this you can find out that the lower heating value of the alcohol is lower than the conventional fuel. Oxygen rated percentage, that is the higher in the methanol. रिसर्च ऑक्टेन नंबर और आरओएन नंबर, द हाईएस्ट आरओएन नंबर इज द मिथेनॉल, दैट इज 108.7 देन द गैसोलीन. मोटर ऑक्टेन नंबर और एमओएन नंबर व्हिच इज हाईएस्ट ऑक्टेन नंबर दैट इज 89.7 दैट इज द इथेनॉल व्हिच इज कंपेयर्ड टू द गैसोलीन. द वैल्यू ऑफ द गैसोलीन मोटर ऑक्टेन नंबर ऑफ द गैसोलीन दैट इज 85. सीटेन नंबर is lower than the diesel. The auto ignition temperature of the alcohol is higher than the conventional fuel. Boiling point of this of the gasoline that is 27 to 225 degrees Celsius. For the diesel it is 74 degrees Celsius. Ethanol, it is 78.3 degrees Celsius. Methanol, it is 64.5 degrees Celsius, and the butanol, it is 118 degrees Celsius. Carbon content as a in percentage, the highest carbon content is diesel, and lower is the methanol. So from here we can find out that the carbon content of the alcohol is lower than the conventional fuel, and the sulfur content is nearly nil. So sulfur content is available only for the conventional fuel. There in the alcohol as an alternative fuel, there are the no sulfur content is available. So students, up to this, is there any query? Hello.
Yes, sir. Samir.
Okay. Up to this, is there any query?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Now moving to the next slide. That is E85. There. E85 means it is a alcohol fuel which is a mixture of 85% ethanol and 15% gasoline by the volume. So E85, which is consist of the 85% ethanol and the 15% gasoline. So this is the mixture of the this is a fuel which is a mixture of these two fuel. So that's why this E85 is also known as a biofuel or the dual fuel. The E85 as fuel which is widely used in Sweden, and it is becoming increasingly common in the US, mainly in the Midwest where the corn is major crop and is the primary source material for ethanol fuel production. So the coming from here we can learn that ethanol is for production of the ethanol, corn take a major component to produce the ethanol. So that's because of the Midwest of this US, the corn is a major crop. So for that reason, the US and the Sweden are use this E85 as their alternative fuel, other conventional vehicles fuel. So this E85 is usually used in the engine and modified to accept the higher concentration of ethanol. Such flexible fuel engines are designed to run any mixture of the gasoline or ethanol with up to 85% ethanol by volume. So in this way it is the engine is designed. So here E85 is the blend of E10 or E15 to reduce the pollution by oxidation. Now, coming to the engine application. So, alcohol is used in the both the engine, SI engine and the CI engine. So let's start with this SI engine. Alcohols have higher anti-knock characteristics compared to the gasoline. For this reason, the alcohol engine compression ratio lies in between 11 is to 1 and 13 is to 1. So for the today's gasoline engines use a compression ratio around the 7 is to 1 to 9 is to 1, which is much too low for the pure alcohol. So for this reason, in a properly designed engine and the fuel system, alcohol produces fewer harmful exhaust emission. So alcohol contains about the half the heat energy of the gasoline per liter. So the stoichiometric ratio is lesser for alcohol than the gasoline engine. So to provide a proper fuel air mixture, a carburetor or a fuel injector's fuel passages should be doubled in area to allow the extra fuel flow. The alcohol does not vaporize as easy as gasoline, so its latent heat of vaporization is much greater. So this effect could helps to cold weather starting. So if the alcohol liquefies in the engine, then it will not be able to burn properly. So thus, the engine may be difficult or even impossible to start in extremely cold climate. So to overcome this, the gasoline is introduced in the engine until the engine start and the warms up. Once the engine warm ups, alcohol when introduced will vaporize quickly and completely and the burn, which is burned normally. Even during the normal operation, additional heat may have to be supplied to completely vaporize alcohol. So the alcohol burns at about half the speed of the gasoline. So as such, ignition timing must be changed so that the more spark advance is provided, which will be give the slow burning alcohol more time to develop the pressure and the power in the cylinder. So this is the way of the SI alcohol is used in this SI engine. So now coming the various methods to apply the alcohol in the SI engine, that is blend, where the alcohol fuel are mixed with the gasoline before injecting the inside the cylinder. Then up to 25% in volume of alcohol are replaced. The effects of the alcohol gasoline blends to regulate the exhaust emission from the SI engine. Alcohol gasoline blends can effectively reduce the NOx and the carbon monoxide emission. So for these reasons, we can easily use the alcohol in the SI engine. Now coming to the CI engines application. Both the fuel alcohol, ethanol and the methanol have the high self-ignition temperature. Hence, the very compression ratio it will be required to the self-ignite them. So that's why it should the engine extremely heavy and the expensive. The better method is to utilize them in the dual fuel operation. So in the dual fuel engine, alcohol is carbureted or injected into the inducted air, and due to the high self-ignition temperature of alcohol, there will be no combustion with the usually diesel compression ratio. A little before the end of the compression stroke, a small quantity of the diesel oil is injected into the combustion chamber through the normal diesel pump and spray via nozzle. So the diesel oil readily ignite and this initiates the combustion in the alcohol air mixture also. So there are the various methods are available to apply the achieving this dual fuel operation in the CI engine. Those are alcohol fumigation, alcohol diesel blend, alcohol diesel emulsification, and last one is dual injection. Now coming with the blending methods. Automobile fuels be oxygenated in order to reduce the air pollution. So in addition to remove of the lead from the gasoline and renew the interest in ethanol as the octane booster. While we use the E10 or the E15 is instant for all the automobiles, a blend which is called as the E85 is intended for the flex fuel vehicle. The E85 is a normally fuel of the mixture of 85% ethanol and 15% gasoline. It can be as high as the 30% gasoline in the cold climate in winter. So the principal reason for blending some gasoline into ethanol for flex the fuel vehicle, which is used to improve the starting in the cold weather. So for this reason, we using the blending methods. That's because of the alcohol. If we use a pure alcohol as an alternative fuel, it faces some problem during the cold climate. To overcome this, we use the gasoline with the mix with the alcohol. Then it will be easy to overcome. So for this reason, we use the blending methods. Ethanol is separated from the water in which it is produced via a process which is called as the distillation. So in the distillation method, ethanol is separated from the water, but there is a little problem is there. The, it is 100% is not working here. You can find out it is up to 90 to 96%. So that in this way, the distillation process does not remove all of the water. So having some water which is mixed in with the fuel, which is actually improves the performance of an IC engine, as the water provides extra mass to absorb the heat of combustion and turn it into the high pressure steam for the mechanical energy. However, water and the gasoline don't mix well, so the water must be removed when producing the ethanol and gasoline blends. So these are the more important things when we are going for to blending the ethanol and the gasoline. We must remove the water, try to remove the water from the ethanol, because water and gasoline are not mixed well. So this dry or anhydrous ethanol is needed to prevent the phase separation of the fuel component in ethanol and the gasoline blends. So these are the way methods of the blending. Now coming to the fumigation methods. Alcohol fumigation is a dual fuel engine operation techniques in which alcohol fuels are pre-mixed with the intake air via the fuel injectors into the cylinder. So alcohol fumigation is a dual fuel method where alcohol fuels are pre-mixed with the intake air and via fuel injector into the cylinder. So as you can see in this picture, this one is the injector, this is the intake valve. So before opening this intake valve, here in the inlet manifold, alcohol is sprayed with the help of the injector, and it's mixed with the air, and after that it will be goes into the combustion chamber or the cylinder. Here we use up to 50% in volume of alcohol. Vaporized alcohol is mixed with the intake air, which lowered the intake mixture temperature and increased its density. So this required the additional carburetor or the vaporizer or injector along with a separate fuel tank line and control to organize these methods. Now coming to the engine performances of this alcohol as in fuel. So students, as you can see here, there are the three kinds of three graphs. This is the torque in Newton meter. Here is the engine speed, and here it is BSFC. BSFC means brake specific fuel consumption. And here three colors are denoted. Three colors are showing. First one is blue color showing the gasoline, red is ethanol, and green is methanol. So from this graph, we can easily study that as increasing the engine speed, as increasing the engine speed, torque reduced. The torque is reduced in case of the gasoline. So in case of the ethanol and methanol, it is reduced, but it is not gradually, it is slightly decreases. So from this graph we can easily find out that the torque or the engine speed, ethanol is the best. Then in the graph of the BSFC, we can find out that the as increase the engine speed, gasoline is lower, but in case of the methanol it is higher. So for increasing the BSFC of the methanol, so you can find that the methanol is the best compared to the gasoline during the BSFC. Now coming to the second graph, this is the combustion efficiency and the engine speed. Here we can see that as we increase the engine speed, the gasoline engine is decreases, where at 1600 rpm the combustion efficiency of the gasoline was near to 98%, and when it is goes to the 3600 rpm engine speed, it is near to 98.2%. But in case of the ethanol, in the 1600 RPM speed, the combustion efficiency, that is 98.2, and in as when the engine speed reach at the 3600 RPM, the combustion efficiency reaches the 98.99%. So in from here we can say that easily, you can easily say the combustion efficiency is increased in case of both ethanol and methanol compared to the gasoline engine, gasoline. Now coming to the third graph, here we can see the engine speed versus brake thermal efficiency. When the engine speed is 1600 rpm, the brake thermal efficiency of the gasoline is above the 20%, and when it is reaches the engine speed as 3600, then the engine speed is firstly it is increases, then it is decreases, and which is reaches up to near to the 20% of the brake thermal efficiency. But for the ethanol and the methanol as an alternative fuel, both the cases improve the brake thermal efficiency during the 1600 rpm to when it is reaches the 3600 rpm. So now coming to the next slide. Here the graph shows the unburned hydrocarbon emission, and this is the, here is the engine speed and this is the carbon monoxide emission. When engine speed is 1600 rpm, the unburned carbon hydrocarbon emissions is rated near to 71 ppm, and when it is reaches 3600 rpm, then the unburned hydrocarbon engine speed is in 1600 rpm, then the unburned hydrocarbon emissions reaches the 220 ppm, and when the engine speed reaches from 1600 to 3600 rpm, it is the value is reaches near to 130 ppm. But in case of the ethanol and methanol, both for the methanol at the starting, but that is 1600 rpm as an engine speed, unburned hydrocarbon emissions value is near to 190 ppm, and when the engine speed reaches 3600 rpm, the unburned hydrocarbon emission is decreases and it reaches up to 100 ppm. So from here we can state that the for the alcohol as an fuel is lower unburned hydrocarbon emission than the gasoline. Now coming to the carbon monoxide emission, when the engine speed is 1600 rpm, carbon emission value is near to 1.3% of in case of this gasoline engine, and when it is reaches 3600 engine speed, then the value is near less than the 1%. And when if we study the ethanol and methanol, both the cases, carbon emission percentage is less than 1% during the 1600 rpm, and when it is reaches 3600 rpm, it is also lower than the 1% of this carbon monoxide emission. So from here we can state that alcohol has a lower carbon emission than the gasoline. Now coming to the next slides, this one is the brake thermal efficiency and the speed. Before this graph we study on the alcohol and the gasoline comparison. Now we can compare the alcohol and the diesel fuel. So here you can see the light circle that is showing the 100% diesel fuel, dark circle showing the 20% ethanol as a fumigation, and the dark diamond shape showing that 20% ethanol as a blend. So here we can see at when the engine speed is 1000 rpm, the brake thermal efficiency of the 100% diesel fuel is near to 19%, and when it is reaches 2000 speed of rp speed in rpm, then the value is near to 17%. So this is showing the graph of the 100% diesel fuel. In case of when we study the 20% ethanol as fumigant, then you can see the at 1000 rpm, The wick thermal efficiency is above 20%, and when it is reaches 200 RPM, so it is showing the value is near to 19% wick thermal efficiency. And when in case of the 20% ethanol as a blending method, 1000 RPM, the value is 20%, and in 2000 RPM, it is near below the 19%. So from here, we can easily state that the brick thermal efficiency is increased than the diesel fuel, than the compared to the other ethanol during the fumigation and the blending methods. Next is graph showing the carbon monoxide versus speed graph. Here you can see the for the 100% diesel fuel, when engine speed is 1000 RPM, the carbon monoxide is in 3%, and when it is engine speed reaches 2000 RPM, then the carbon monoxide reaches 5%, and when this is showing the 100% diesel fuel. And if we study then the 10-20% ethanol as a fumigant, then we can see that in case of the 1000 in engine speed, then the carbon monoxide percentage, it is above 4%, and when engine speed reaches 2000 RPM, it provides the 6%. And in case of 20% ethanol as a blending method, when the engine speed is 1000 RPM, the carbon monoxide percentile is 4. Near to 5%, and it reaches the above the 6% when the engine speed reach the 2000 RPM. So from here we can see that we can state that easily the carbon monoxide percentile is increases in case of the alcohol than the diesel fuel. Now coming to the next slide, here as we can see the smoke absorption coefficient and the speed graph. For the 100% diesel fuel, when the engine speed is 1000 RPM, smoke absorption coefficient is near to 1.5. is 1.5, and when engine speed reaches 2000 RPM, then the smoke capacity reaches near to 0.7 value. So here the smoke capacity is decreases in case of the 100% diesel fuel. When we use the 20% ethanol as fumigation, then we can see that when the engine speed is 1000 RPM, the value of smoke absorption coefficient, it is 1.2, near to 1.0, and it when it engine speed is reaches 2000 RPM, then the smoke absorption coefficient reaches below the 0.4. so here is also a smoke absorption coefficient is decreases. So from this graph we can easily say that alcohol is decreases more decreases the smoke absorption coefficient than the diesel fuel. Now coming to the next slide, that is shoot versus speed graph. When the engine speed 1000 RPM in case of the diesel fuel, it reaches the near to the 6 मिलीग्राम पर केजी एंड व्हेन इट इज रीच इज द इंजन स्पीड अप टू द 2000 आरपीएम देन इट इज द वैल्यू इज नियर टू द 400 एंड इन दिस फिगर वी कैन सी द इफ द 20 इथेनॉल इज ब्लेंडिंग मेथड इथेनॉल इज ब्लेंड मेथड देन द शूट परसेंटेज इज ऑल्सो डिक्रीजेज एंड द फ्यूमिगेशन मेथड शूट परसेंटेज शूट इज ऑल्सो डिक्रीजेज एंड इन हेयर यू कैन इजिली स्टेट दैट द ड्यूरिंग द ब्लेंडिंग ड्यूरिंग द फ्यूमिगेशन मेथड विच इज हाईली डिक्रीजेज द शूट वैल्यू कंपेयर टू द डीजल इंजिन डीजल फ्यूल. Now coming to the third graph. Here we can see the comparison of hydrocarbon and the speed. When the engine speed is 1000 RPM, the hydrocarbon of the diesel 100% diesel fuel is value is near to 400, and when engine speed reaches the 2000 RPM, then the hydrocarbon value of the diesel fuel it is above the 800 hydrocarbon, and in case of the blending method it is above the 600 above 600 during the 1000 rpm, and when it is reaches the rpm engine speed in up to 2000 rpm it reaches the above the 1000 ppm. So from here the hydrocarbon is increases than the diesel fuel. Students, up to this, is there any queries?
Hello, sir.
Hello. Hello.
Sir, বলছি, what is shoot, sir? গ্রাফে একটা ছিল বাসের উপর দিকে shoot.
শুটটা হচ্ছে যখন আমাদের গাড়ি এমিশন হয় তখন যে কার্বন পার্টিকেল গুলো বেরোয় না সেগুলোকে আমরা শুট বলে থাকি, যেমন কিছু কার্বন ফর্ম কার্বন বেরোয় থাকে কালো মতো সেগুলোকে আমরা শুট বলি.
হ্যাঁ স্যার, ওকে স্যার, ওকে, থ্যাংক ইউ.
এনি আদার কোশ্চেন্স? হ্যালো.
নো স্যার.
ওকে. So now coming to the advantage and disadvantages of this alcohol. The advantages are it is a high octane fuel with the anti-knock index. With anti-knock index number of over 100. Number two, engines using high octane fuel can run more efficiently by using the higher compression ratio. Alcohols have the higher flame speed, it produce less overall emission. It produce less overall emission compared to the gasoline. When alcohols are burned, it forms more moles of exhaust gases, which gives the higher pressure and more power in the expansion stroke. So it has a higher latent heat of vaporization, which result in a cooler intake process. So this raises the volumetric efficiency of the engine and it reduces the required work input in the compression stroke. Alcohols have the lower sulfur content in the fuel and it reduces the petroleum imports and the transportation. So these are the advantages of this alcohol. Now coming to the disadvantages. Alcohols have low energy content, or in the other word, the calorific value of the alcohol is less than the conventional fuel. With equal thermal efficiency and similar engine output uses, the twice as much fuel would have to be purchased. Even with the low energy content of the fuel, engine power for a given displacement would be about the same. The lower air fuel ratio needed by the alcohol. Alcohol contains oxygen and thus requires the less air for the stoichiometric combustion. More fuel can be burned with the same amount of air. Alcohol is much more corrosive than the gasoline on copper, brush, aluminium, rubber, and many plastics. So these are the most important limitation for the alcohol. This puts some restriction on the design and manufacturing of the engine where to be used with this fuel. Methanol is a very corrosive on metal, and it has a poor cold weather starting characteristic due to the low vapor pressure and the evaporation. Students, is there any queries on the alcohol as an alternative fuel?
Yes, স্যার
হ্যাঁ বলো
স্যার মিঠুন মজুমদারের দুটো প্রশ্ন আছে স্যার, আমি করছি। হ্যাঁ বলছি স্যার, অটোমোবাইল ফুয়েল সিস্টেমে ড্রাই অ্যালকোহল আর ওয়েট অ্যালকোহল এই দুটোর মধ্যে কোনটা ইউজ হয় স্যার?
আমরা ওয়েট ইউজ করি, যেরকম আমরা পেট্রোল ডিজেল ইউজ করে থাকি লিকুইড ফরমেশনে, সেরকম আমরা এখানে লিকুইড ফরমেশনে ইউজ করি। যখন আমরা ড্রাই করবো সলিড ফরমেশন চলে আসবে, তো আমরা লিকুইড ফরমেশনে আমরা অ্যালকোহল ইউজ করে থাকি।
ওকে স্যার, ওকে স্যার। আর স্যার সেকেন্ড প্রশ্নটা হচ্ছে স্যার, আদার কোনো কার্বন কম্পাউন্ড ইউজ কেন করা হয় না?
আদার কোনো,
কার্বন কম্পাউন্ড কেন ইউজ করা হয় না?
দেখো যখনই আমি এখানে এখানে একটু আগে বুঝলে আমরা করলাম, এর ক্যালোরিফিক ভ্যালুটা এমনিতেই কম, যখন আমরা কার্বন কন্টেন্ট বাড়াবো তখন এ কিন্তু প্রপার ওয়েতে কম্বাসন করতে পারবে না। তো
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা,
যখনই কম্বাসন আমার প্রপারলি হবে না, তখনই আবার সেই সিমিলার ওয়েতে কনভেনশনাল ফিউয়েলের ফিউয়েলের ভেহিকেলের মতো এক্সস্টে প্রচুর পরিমাণে পলিউশন তো ক্রিয়েট করবে, এই কারণে এগুলো অ্যাভয়েড করা হয় আর কি।
ওকে ওকে স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার।
ওকে, সো স্টুডেন্টস ইজ দেয়ার এনি কোয়েরি আদার্স? ওকে তাহলে তুমি, ওকে স্টুডেন্টস।